So if you guys remember, we are doing the AAA concept. So we have finished AAA in the last class. So let's do lab on this, okay? So let me just brief what is this. Say for example, if I have a user sitting here, okay, and if he wants to do a SSH on the ASA firewall, okay. So what happens is basically we have to write his username and password within the ASA firewall, but that is a manual approach. If we have 100 of devices, network devices, routers, which is ASA firewall, so we have to define username and password on all the devices. Okay, so what we do normally is we keep a centralized AAA server, and in the back end, the ASA will be connected to this AAA server. Okay, so whenever he will input his username with password, the information will be carried to the AAA server. AAA server will check it local database, and then it will notify ASA firewall that yes, this is a write credential and we can grant him the access, and ASA firewall will open the connection for this user. And that is how then we can input any commands, or we can configure anything. Okay, so all the things whatever we normally do, okay, normally if this user will input 10 commands, so all the activity will also be getting stored here. Okay, all the user activity will also be getting stored here. So let's do a practical lab here. Okay, so this is my GNS lab, and let me tell you about the lab. Okay, so this is a user belonging to VLAN 10, and this is the IP address. Okay, and this is ASA firewall, and this is the AAA server. So AAA has two protocol. One is called as TCAS, and the other one is called as Radius protocol. Okay, so first I'm going to configure TCAS protocol. We will prove the concept, and then we will go with Radius, and then we will prove the Radius concept. Okay, so basically when he is trying to log in to the ASA firewall, the ASA firewall will in return send those credentials to the server and make it sure that that is the right user, and then the server will respond back to ASA firewall, yes, he is the right person. Okay, so most of enterprise work on centralized AAA server. Okay, no one is going to configure the user accounts on each one of the devices. Okay, that is not how the enterprise work. We configure AAA server, and all these devices will be mapped with the AAA server. It can be printer, it can be network devices like routers, switches, Wi-Fi modem or firewalls. So they all will be stored up in the AAA server. So any user who wants to connect, say for example, if this user wants to SSH or telnet this router, the router will send the backend packet to the server, AAA server, and then it will inform the device whether that is a right credential or if that is a wrong credential. Okay, so fine. So let's start with the first protocol, TCAS, which works on TCP 49. Okay, so I have started these instances. Okay, ASA firewall, I have started. I have started the switch. I have started the AAA server, and I have started the user. Okay, so let's take the console now. Let me also capture the packet show you, to show you the packet level of syntax, okay, the packet level flow. So let me tell you about my AAA server before we get started. So the AAA server that I am using is from the GNS website, okay. It's a Linux based AAA server. So if you go and Google for any of free AAA server, you can get plenty of them on Linux based or Windows based. So you have to have your VM or Docker or a software and then install it. Okay. So in this case, this is a Docker. Okay. It's called as Docker. The Docker consists of a Linux platform and they have developed the package for TechAS, and also they have developed the package for Radius. Okay. And for TechAS, the developer has mentioned the username. Okay. So the username, he says that this is the username and this is the password for TechAS. And for Radius, he say make use of Bob and make use of GNS3 as the password. So this has been hard coded by the developer of this Docker, but we can change it. Okay. We can change it, but it is not required for us to go through all the coding stuff and all. We are more bothered about the network things. Okay. So in case you want to see where this package lies, so I can show you. If you go to cat, okay, if you do cat etc free radius, okay, /3.0 users, okay. So this is developed by one of the developer, and he has written all the Radius script that is required for Radius to communicate, and he has mentioned or he has designed two users. Okay, he says try to log in with Alice with password GNS3, and or try to log in with Bob with password GNS3. Okay, so either one of them should work, and that means our Radius is working fine. Okay, similar way, he has also developed package for TechAS. Okay. And if you check out this, so this is a package developed by the developer for TechAS. And he says the password is GNS for the script, and also username is GNS3. Okay. So we are going to make use of the script which is already been developed and been submitted to the GNS3. Okay. And how do you download there? If you go to GNS3 appliance, you can click on this. You can search for AAA Docker. Okay. So it's over here. So this is the AAA Docker given by GNS3. Okay. So otherwise you would have to go to some freeware. Okay. And which could be integrated with GNS3. So that would be a lengthy process, but because of the developer, we are helpful that we can save our lot of time. Okay, so there are many freewares which you can just download and work on. Okay, one second. So let's come towards the lab. Okay, so I just discussed about this Stalker. In case if you want to set up your own lab and practice, so you can just go to GNS and have your copy downloaded, and you can set this up. Okay, so regarding the configuration, let me go to my ASA firewall first. Okay, let me configure the SSH, because at this moment no one would be allowed to take my SSH. Okay, so I have to enable that. Okay, I need to enable, then only SSH will be granted. So who is the user? That is 10. series user. Okay, I want to allow this user to take SSH of ASA firewall. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to say SSH should be granted to the users of this network. Okay, and over this interface. So once this is done, we are going to generate some SSH key. Okay, so let's remove any RSA key which would have been cached in this ASA firewall, and we can generate a fresh one. Okay, so let's say crypto key generate RSA modulus 1024. So you guys might be knowing by now, for SSH we need minimum of 768 modulus, but we are going with 124 just because it's an average value. Okay, if you do question mark, you can see 768 is minimum for SSH. Okay, if you have anything lesser than 768, your SSH will not work. So you can go with 4096, but thing is, the encryption on one side and decryption on another side will take a lot of time. Okay, and it is not advisable that this impacts your the internal resource of the hardware also. Okay, so we are not going with highest security for our lab setup. Let's go with the normal 1024. Okay, let's do enter, and the key has been generated. Okay, so if you want to see, you can check it out. So it says we have enabled SSH, the timeout is 5 by default, this is a key exchange. Okay, fine. Let's configure the TechAS now. Okay, TechAS server. So let's say AAA server, let's define a word, let's say it's a TechAS server. What is the protocol this is responsible for? Okay, so we have two protocol, the two interested protocol are TechAS and RADIUS, but we are starting right now with TechAS and then we will go with RADIUS. Okay, so for now let me take it as TechAS, enter. Okay, I'm going to define how many maximum failed attempts should be given to the users. Okay, say someone is continuously, or someone is trying to log in, okay, continuously 10 times or 15 times, which can which looks suspicious behavior, like someone trying to enter wrong password and trying to steal your data. Okay, brute force attacks. Okay, so we are going to limit that. We are going to say the maximum 3 failed attempts is allowed. Okay, then come out of this, we are now going to define the TechAS server. Okay, so is asking for the name, so this is that name which we have defined. Okay, and where is this TechAS server located? Where have you installed your AAA server? So basically AAA server is on this IP. okay, so I'm going to copy paste that IP over here. Okay, so before that I need to make use of the interface. Okay, on which interface the TechAS server is going to be laid down. So it's HR VLANs, host, and the IP address of the TechAS server. Okay, .1.1.73. okay, and what is the password for this? The string for this, it is GNS3, and good to come out. Okay, now important thing, say for example it's all good until your AAA server is up and running fine. That means you're trying to SSH this, okay? Your ASA will send that information to AAA server, and AAA server will say, yes, this is the right user, and then you will be granted the access. Now, what if AAA server is down during the peak hours? So you just cannot rely on AAA server. Okay. There are the best practices. Keep another AAA server. Okay. You can keep another AAA server on different VLAN, or you can also have a radius configured. So you have multiple options here. Primary AAA server. If that goes down, you have another server as a backup. If that is also working, if that is also down, then you have a radius server. Okay. But let's go with a simplest thing. Say, for example, if this is down and you don't have any other servers. Okay. So in that case, you would have a master username and password manually created on ASA firewall. So how it works is you're trying to do SSH on the ASA firewall, but AAA is down. You are going to set a command saying that when AAA server is down, let's have a backup plan. That backup plan is, let's have a user, the local username and password effective. Okay. But when AAA server is up, then the local username and password shouldn't be effective. Okay. So we can do it on lab and we can see what I actually mean to. Okay. So let me write the command. Let's say AAA authentication on SSH, okay, should be active on TechAS, okay, but if TechAS server is down, then as a backup procedure, let's have it local, but local will be effective once TechAS server is down, okay. If TechAS server is up, that means your local will not be working, okay. So we have set that, and we can also set the local master password. So in case of some fail, in case of some outage, okay. So this is my the local username password. Okay. So we are good. We can do a testing right now. Okay. So before running a test, let's see my TechAS server is running or not. Okay. So I am going to AAA server. I am going to input this command, which will give me the status of AAA server. Okay, so what does this say? Okay, this say my AAA server, the TechAS features are running up, so I am good to start now. Okay, so for that I am going to the user. I will do SSH on ASA firewall. Okay, so what is the IP of ASA firewall? So this is the IP address. Okay. But since this is a router, the right format to do SSH is SSH-L. I'm going to input the username. Okay. So what is the username? Say let's take the local username. This shouldn't work for us because the AAA is running right now, right? So, but let's take this. Okay. Let's consider what happens. And what is the IP of ASA firewall? Okay. So when I do SSH, okay, I'm getting a prompt. What is the local username password? Admin and Cisco. Okay, so do you see when I put admin and Cisco, it is not letting me to enter ASA firewall, even though we have configured that as a master username password. The reason is, because of this command. Okay, this command says our primary credential server has to be validated on the TechAS. Okay, and what is the TechAS username password? So let me write it down here. The TechAS coder or the developer has given us this username and password, okay, for TechAS feature to test. So now instead of admins and Cisco, let's try GNS3 and GNS3. Okay, so I'm going to change this. I'm going to make it GNS3. Let's make it GNS3 as password. And yes, we are in. Okay, so what happened? Your user who is trying to do SSH on ASA firewall. Okay, ASA firewall is being mapped with the AAA server. All the credentials were sent to AAA. The coder of the TechAS script has mentioned it GNS and GNS3, and that is how we are now successfully logged in. Okay, and if you see the packets on Wireshark, okay, so this is my Wireshark packet, and if you were present in my last class, you know TechAS is a TCP protocol running on 49. So all TCP connection will go through three-way handshake. Okay. Okay, not an issue. I can show directly over here. Okay. So when I initiated my SSH over TechAS, if you see the first three packet, they are three-way handshake. Okay. Your user is sending sync packet. The ASA firewall being acting as server, sending sync acknowledge and then acknowledge packet. Okay. So after three-way handshake, the actual TechAS packet will start flowing. Okay. Now what happened? The TechAS authentication was carried. The GNS3 and GNS3 will get validated over the script, and then it will say, yes, this is the right username password. We can open the connection for this user. Okay. So that is what this things happen. Okay. Okay. So let me open up the packet. Okay, so if you see this, it's working on TCP 49. This is a TechAS data. Okay, and so on. And one more thing I told you, TechAS will encrypt all your packet. Okay, they are not visible, they are not plain text, whereas Radius is plain text. Okay, so TechAS is clear, I guess. So let's now do the next one, that is Radius. Okay, I'm going to make use of the same Docker, but different username password will be taken up. The developer say for Radius, he has designed it for Bob and GNS3 as a password. Okay, so we are going to do that. So before that, let me validate if my AAA is running the service for Radius. Okay, that is important. If the service is not running, then you have to restart or reinstall the Docker. Service free Radius start. Okay, this is a good news that it is also running. The free Radius is running. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create Radius configuration now. Okay. So let's go. So all the other things like SSH generation of RSA key remains same. Okay. So let's create a Radius server now. Okay. Our ASA firewall. So AAA server. Let's define it as Radius. Let's say it is now running on Radius protocol. Let's say the maximum failed attempt will be 3. Come out of this. Okay. Let's say AAA server Radius, which is located on HR VLAN. Okay. It is being mapped to internal or centralized AAA server, which is hosted on 10.1.1.73. The key we would be using is GNS3. Okay, come out of this. Okay, before coming out of that, there was very important thing. Okay, the important thing is for Radius, if you remember, the theoretical topic that we discussed yesterday regarding the port number. Okay, so initially when radius was unofficially declared, we had two different port number, 1645 and 1646. Okay, but after 1990s or 2000, the radius was documented. Okay, and once it was documented, the latest official port numbers are UDP 1812 and UDP 1813. Okay, so we have to hard code these these protocol numbers. Okay, if we don't, then by default all your devices are going to consider this, and then that can cause communication loss. Okay, so how I'm going to hard code the port number? So under this command, okay, I'm going to say authentication port must be 1812. Okay, and accounting port should be 1813. So this is only for radius. The problem was only with radius, not with TechAs. Okay, so go back to the last class and once again go through the theoretical part. Okay, so you will understand. Okay, so that is done. Let's say the primary is going to be radius now, and backup would be the local. Okay, so I'm going to say AAA authentication SSH console. The primary would be radius and backup would be local. Okay, fine. So it is giving me some error. I need to check if TechAs is not trying to overlap here. Okay, yes, TechAs is trying to overlap. So let me remove that. Okay, normally what I do is I try to restart and reconfigure, because that is much more easier. Okay, anyway, let's try this way. Okay, so now I have set radius as my primary and local to be my backup in case radius fail. Okay, okay, so let's double check if we are all good. Okay, this is important command. Okay, fine, so we are good to test now. Okay, so I'm going back to the user. Now it is not GNS3. Okay, the reason it is not GNS3 is because the developer of that Docker says for radius make username as a Bob. Okay, so I'm going to follow his instruction, and he says the password should be GNS3, and yes, we are in. Okay, now if I try to do the local username password, will it take me? No, it is not taking me, and I have set 3 maximum failed attempt, and see, after 3 maximum failed attempt, my complete connection is lost. Okay, so that proves that AAA server is working, and the packet levels can be seen over here. Okay, so that was a TCP connection, 3-way handshake. Now when you see radius, it's a UDP packet. Okay, and for UDP there is nothing called the 3-way handshake. That is why the radius is straightforward. Your user or your ASA firewall is sending a request to the server. Okay, who is 1.1.1? This is your ASA firewall. Okay, this is your ASA firewall. This is your AAA server. Okay, so when user is trying to SSH, your ASA in the background is sending those packets to the radius server over radius protocol with the instruction access request. Okay, now your AAA server will go through its database. It will say yes, this is a matching username password, and let's allow this. Okay, and that is how you got the ARP generated, and that is how you were able to connect. Now when we tried with the local username password, the request first went to ASA firewall. ASA firewall forwarded it to a AAA server, but you were trying the request with the local username credential admin and Cisco, which is not right. That is why your radius server rejected that packet. Okay, it said I'm going to reject. And all the 3 times you just tried to do wrong username password, and you all got is rejection message. Okay, so everything is visible when you have Wireshark in front of you. Okay, so let's see the UDP packets now. If I go on click on this, this is my user UDP packet. So it says destination port on 1812. Okay, so that is why I was telling that on ASA firewall, let's hard code the port number to 1812. If it was left default, then what would happen is on one side it is 1645 and on other side it is 1812. Okay, you should remember officially now it's 1812. Okay, so anywhere whenever you are configuring radius, it is a good practice you hard code the command. Okay, it's see some of the software platform have considered that officially it is 1845 and 1846. But yes, let's not take a risk by pre-assuming the things. Okay, so we can hard code the things so that we don't fall into any outage or any kind of the disturbance. Okay. Okay, fine. So this was regards to the packet. You can see all the ports like 1812. Okay, you can see the. These are 1812 UDP packets, the headers. Okay, now important thing, let's say AAA server is down at this moment. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete one of the link. Okay, so I'm just going to delete this. Now AAA server is down, so do you think your AAA credential should work? Okay, so what is AAA credential? This was your credential, right? So let's try. See, it is not working right now. It is not working because there is no packet being sent, because that is, there is no link connected. Okay, there is no link connected. Your ASA firewall doesn't know where is AAA server because the link has been terminated, right? And there's no way that this can be authenticated. So it all proves that our AAA was very functional in the previous scenarios, but now it is not. But we have also done a good job that we have set some revert back process. That is, when AAA server is not reachable, we have our local username and password, right? So now that is coming into functional. Okay, so that is being functional. So let's say it's admin and password is Cisco, and yes, we are in. Okay, so few minutes back the admin Cisco wasn't working. If you remember, admin password, admin and Cisco wasn't working, but now yes, it's working. Okay, the thing is AAA has been removed, and we have set our rules that if AAA is not functional, then let us log in via local. Okay, how can I check that? So this command says that if my radius is not functional, then let me have a backup plan. Let me have the local effective. Okay, but yes, when my radius is up, local doesn't play any role in your configuration. Okay, local is just a backup plan. Okay, so that's regards to AAA. So any doubt before we move on to the next topic?
Sir, I haven't. So if I have multiple clients, they are connecting from outside, from VPN to VPN. So I'll share the username. I'll create the username, password, and pre-shared key in my local firewall. So these rules are applicable for those outside users also. So that radius will resolve that.
Yes, it is applicable. And why it is applicable is, say for example, let's consider a user who is your employee, but he is doing work from home on that day. Okay, so using VPN, he is connecting to ASA firewall, and once he is connecting to the corporate network, he might take the login on other devices, right? So his first step is to get this connected, that is his VPN get connected. Once he's into the VPN, once he's into your corporate, then basically he's same as being inside this office only. And from there, he can take any any other network devices. Okay, for him the first step is to be in VPN setup. Okay, without VPN he cannot log into any other devices.
So when in FortiGate, when I was going to create username, so that time that will be asked some prompt, set as a local user or AAA SSO user like that.
Yes, see, local is created in case of a backup procedure. For you, the main setup is AAA only. Okay, you're going to set up all users on AAA, but you're also setting a backup plan. Okay, saying that if AAA server is down for some reason, the users can still log in. But usually what we do is we create all AAA IDs for users, and we create one admin username and password, which is not shared with employees. It will be with the lead, or it can be with the manager, or it can be with the technical members only. Okay.
Yeah.
These will be not shared with all other technical engineers. Only there is some genuine reason that he is a part of some upgrade process, but on that fine day, the AAA is going through upgradation process or AAA is down. In that case, if he needs a login access on the other devices, then yes, this can be shared. But again, this is not shared with all of them. It is kept confidential. Okay.
Okay. So here, AAA, we are able to maintain the log also, right?
Yes. AAA server will give you all the user activity. Like, for example, the user ID XYZ logged at this time. He has executed these commands. What is his hours of duration in one of the firewall? So everything it is can be visible.
So same like that setup in my DC, we have syslog. I set up the syslog and I integrate the in my network devices with syslog. So the both work is same, right? AAA and syslog. So they'll also carry the logs.
The thing is, they are same. Okay, syslog, AAA logs, and SNMP logs. Okay, they will give almost the same benefit of all the other they can be made same, but again it depends on company to company. Okay, some company take a Cisco product, and Cisco product, there is something called Cisco collector. So one product can give you all the three features. Okay, now similar way, some companies will go with external syslog server from like SolarWinds. AAA, they can go with some freeware. SNMP, they can go with some PRTG. So it's a company design on which they are investing. But
SNMP.
Yes, HP SolarWinds. HP. I think NN.
NNMI.
Yes.
NNMI.
Yeah, NMMI is good product, yes, right? Yes. So this depends on company standard. Which, like, say for example, your company is investing on the HP product. Might be your company is investing for syslog on some other product, or AAA on other vendors. For AAA,
we are using syslog also in our internal server. We made one server.
Okay.
From our,
yeah. So now what Cisco does is, Cisco wants to kill its competitor. So what Cisco did is, say for example, syslog, AAA, SNMP are three technology which can be interrelated. So Cisco had a product called Cisco ACS earlier. Okay.
ACS.
One second.
Cisco ICE. ISE.
Yes, yes. Cisco ICE is a new product. I don't know, my laptop suddenly got stuck. Okay, so what I was telling was, Cisco had a product called Cisco ACS server, which is end of life. Now they introduce Cisco ICE. So ICE is very, it's like very huge in its own technology. Okay, it can have lot of things in it, like syslog, the user activities, the BYOD concept, bring your own device concept, the MDM concept, like mobile device management. So it has a lot of facility in one hardware device. So that is to kill the competitor. So you don't have to go to HP, SolarWinds, PRTG. You can just stick with Cisco ICE server and you can have everything in that dashboard. So
centrally managed.
Yes, it is centralized, and in that dashboard you can see everything, even the utilization, what is the utilization going on the interface. So a lot of things is there on Cisco ICE server. So depends on company to company on what they are investing and what is the design that they are investing. All cannot afford paying so much of revenue on the software. So some also go with the free weights and then customize it according to their requirement. Okay.
Sir, I have 40 SIEM to collect the logs from my FortiGate and users. So like that same product we have in Cisco also?
For collecting the logs, you're telling?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, in Cisco, we have something called Cisco Collectors. So this is integrated with all the company syslog servers. It will collect everything. Okay. So this smart collectors will collect all the details, and it will be stored in the device. It can also run the job, like if you're setting up some command like show run, show interface brief. So these can also pull those command and save in something called as Cisco network profile. Okay, so you can have these sort devices integrated on the customer side. Okay, because some customer, they don't let the third party to have the SSH, direct SSH. Okay, say for example, this is company XYZ. Okay, if you are here working here, they don't let you direct SSH to do or to on their device. So what you do is you install these Cisco collectors, the network profile manager, and these are the software which runs on SNMP protocol. They will take the polling, discovery process, all those things. They will collect all the information and they will be stored in this software. Now you will be having access to this software and you can take all the running configuration, interface configuration, all those things, but you will not have direct access on these devices. This is for security concerns. A company don't let to do SSH directly. Instead, they will have this kind of application, and they will allow few commands to be sent to these applications. If you need any extra command, you have to write an email to their network team, ask for output for so and so command, and if they are okay, they will give it to you.
Yeah, same thing. I'm doing that one. So I configured my IoT devices. Those are in outside in field. So all data will be captured from NNMI.
Okay. Yes. So company to company, they have their own standards.